Reading from Canto 9, Chapter 10, Verse Number 27. Navai Veda Mahabhaga Bhavana Kama Vasham Gata Tejanu Bhavam Sitaya Yena Nito Dasham Imam. Word to word meaning. Na, not. Why? Indeed. Veda, did know. Mahabhaga, O greatly fortunate one. Bhavan, yourself. Kama Vasham, influenced by lusty desires. Gataha, having become. Tejaha, by influence. Anubhavam, as a result of such influence. Sitaya, of Mother Sita. Ena, by which. Nitaha, brought into. Dasham, condition. Imam, like this. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. O greatly fortunate one, you came under the influence of lusty desires, and therefore you could not understand the influence of Mother Sita. Now, because of her curse, you have been reduced to this state, having been killed by Lord Ramachandra. Purport. Not only was Mother Sita powerful, but any woman who follows in the footsteps of Mother Sita can also become similarly powerful. There are many instances of this in the history of Vedic literature. Whenever we find a description of an ideal chaste woman, Mother Sita is among them. Mandodari, the wife of Ravana, was also very chaste. Similarly, Draupadi was one of the five exalted chaste woman. As a man must follow great personalities like Brahma and Narada, the woman must follow the path of such ideal women as Sita, Mandodari and Draupadi. By staying chaste and faithful to her husband, a woman enriches herself with supernatural powers. It is a moral principle that one should not be influenced by lusty desires for another's wife. Matravat paradareshu. An intelligent person must look upon another's wife as being like his mother. This is a moral injunction from Chanakya shloka. Matravat paradareshu paradravyeshu loshtavrat atmavat sarvabhuteshu ya pashyati sah panditaha. One who considers another's wife as his mother, another's possession as a lump of a dirt, and treats all other living beings as he would himself, is considered to be learned. Thus, Ravana was condemned not only by Lord Ramachandra, but even by his own wife, Mandodari. Because she was a chaste woman, she knew the power of another chaste woman, especially such a wife as Mother Sita. Om Ajnanati Mirandhasya Jnananjanam Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Guruvai Namaha Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangum Langayate Girim Yat Kripatamaham Vande Sri Gurum Dinatarinam Paramanandha Madhavam Namom Vishnupadaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharane Nirvishesha Shunyavadhi Paschatya Deshatarane Nityananda Maham Naomi Sarvananda Karamparam Harinama Pradam Deva Mamaduta Shiromanim Ananda Leela Maya Vigrahaya Hemam Badivya Chavi Sundaraya Tasmai Mahaprem Rasa Pradaya Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jai. I think this will go back. Okay. Hare Krishna. So our class will be in three phases. First is, we are going to describe about the pastimes of Lord Ramchandra, which were discussed in this chapter. Secondly, we will discuss about the current verse, and then gradually we will try to understand the purport. So I wish to seek all of your blessings. I am certainly not qualified to sit in a Vyasasana and speak such elevated topic, but for my own purification, I will try my level best. The son of Maharaj Khatwang. Khatwang Maharaj was a personality who was been invited by the demigods to fight against the demons. So Khatwang Maharaj went there and he defeated the demons and everything was over, the war was over. And the demigods requested Khatwang Maharaj, what boon do you want? So Khatwang Maharaj said, how much time do I have left in my life? The demigod said, only a small amount of time is left. Then Khatwang Maharaj said, without the time zone problem, please transfer him immediately to the earthly planets. And as soon as they were transferred, Khatwang Maharaj fixed his mind unto the lotus feet of Lord Adokshaja and attained perfection. The associates of the Lord of Vaikuntha, they came and took away Khatwang Maharaj. And those demigods who transferred him a muhurta before, they were showering flowers on Khatwang Maharaj. So that is the glory of Khatwang Maharaj. And his son was Dirgabahu and his son was the celebrated Maharaj Raghu. And from Raghu came Aja and from Aja came Dasharatha. Shukdev Goswami mentions, Tasyapi Bhagavan Esha Sakshat Brahma Mayohari Anshashena Chaturg Aghat Putratvam Parthita Surai Rama Lakshmana Bharat Shatrugna Iti Sangyaya. The demigods, they prayed to Lord Hari to please kindly appear. And on the request of the demigods, the Supreme Lord Hari not only appeared in one form, but he appeared in four forms. In the name of Bharat, Rama, Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrugna. And these are all incarnations of the Supreme Lord Shri Hari. Now the pastimes of Lord Ramchandra are unlimited. But we'll try to summarize it because it is related to our subject matter and gradually we'll come to today's verse. Once Vishwamitra Muni was being troubled by so many demons. So Vishwamitra Muni went to Dasharatha and he took Rama and Lakshmana with him. And then with the help of Rama and Lakshmana, Vishwamitra Muni was able to defeat all the demons. And the pastimes of Lord Ramachandra are very, very wonderful. Shukadeva Goswami compares them to a baby elephant. He says that there was an assembly where Sita was supposed to choose her husband. And there was a bow which was so heavy that 300 men will need to carry it. And the competition was that if someone ties a string to it, then he will marry Sita. So all the great personalities from all over the universe, they made an attempt, but none succeeded. Even Ravana made an attempt to do that. Finally, Lord Ramchandra very easily, he came. Hanumanji's army is here. So, Lord Ramchandra very easily, he tied the string and he got married to Mother Sita. So, in this way, the Lord's activities are very, very wonderful. But as soon as the marriage was performed, Parshuram came. And Parshuram said, who is this another Ram? There is only one Ram in this whole universe, and that is Parshuram. Who is this another Ram? And although this Parashuramji was a Shaktyamesha avatar. But still he did not identify Lord Ramchandra as the supreme personality of Godhead. So he challenged him. He challenged Lord Ramchandra. And Lord Ramchandra, he was very kind, he was very merciful. And he was speaking in a way as a Kshatriya will speak to a Brahmana with good respect. But Parshuram on the other hand he was chastising Lord Ramachandra. He was abusing Lord Ramachandra. Because he was a Brahmana, but he took a role of a Kshatriya and he killed so many Kshatriyas. 21 generation he finished. And now he was thinking that someone is here who has broken the Haradhanush. So now he wants to start that again. So he came with that intention to the assembly of Videha. But when he saw Lord Ramchandra and when he gave his Vishnu Dhanu to Lord Ramachandra, and as soon as he was giving that bow to Lord Ramachandra, immediately as soon as that happened, he saw the universal form of Lord Ramachandra. He saw Lord Vishnu and everything. And he was convinced that this personality is the supreme personality of Godhead. So, the marriage took place, everything went fine. And because of Kaikai, it happened that Lord Ramchandra had to go to forest for exile for 14 years. And it was only for Ramchandra to go. But Sita also went with Lord Ramachandra. It is very important that why Sita has to go? Because Sita was the wife. If she takes the pleasure of sitting next to Lord Ramchandra when she was a king, coronated as a king, then she was also willing to accept the hardships of the forests. So she willingly accepted to go, although she was not bound to go. And while wandering in the forest, Lord Ramachandra accepted a very hardship, very hardship. So we shall also understand this Krishna consciousness means we have to work very hard. Only then, Mother Yashoda also, when she was churning the butter and everything, she was working very hard for Krishna. Then Krishna woke up and came to see her. So Krishna consciousness means it's not an easy going life. Krishna consciousness means we have to work hard for Krishna. Devotional service means we have to work hard. It is not an easy going life. If we work hard for Krishna's pleasure, for the pleasure of the spiritual master, then Krishna will be very pleased and he will like to come and see us. So Lord Ramchandra is showing an example. And when Sita and Lord Ramachandra with Lakshmana were in exile at that time, in Nasik, Surupanaka, the sister of Ravana came there and she was very lustily attracted toward Lord Ramachandra and Lakshmana, and she proposed to marry. But on the instructions of Lord Ramachandra, Lakshmana cut her nose and her ears, and with that terrible face she went to Ravana. And when Surupanaka went to Ravana, Surupanaka described the beauty of Sita, and hearing that beauty of Sita, Ravana became very lusty. And immediately when a person hears, a very powerful person, he hears a very beautiful story or life of a very beautiful woman, the first thought comes that how should I get her? So Ravana, immediately he left and he came to Nasik and he sent Marich, his servant Marich, to bewilder to change the situation. And Marich was he took a form of a golden deer, and Lord Ramachandra went behind it, Lakshmana went behind it, and Ravana kidnapped Mother Sita. It was a shameful act, but Ravana, he kidnapped Mother Sita and took away to Lanka. And while taking her, so many people tried to stop Ravana from doing that. So many people gave so many instructions, and one of them was Jatayu. But Jatayu tried his best to fight with Ravana, but somehow he got defeated. But somehow he gave that message to Lord Rama, and he left his body in the lap of Lord Ramachandra. So that was a good fortune of a vulture. What is the value of a vulture? But he engaged his body in the service of Lord Ramchandra by informing that message and fighting against Ravana. Ravana was very powerful. It was not easy for Jatayu to fight against Ravana. But still Jatayu fought for Lord Ramachandra. Understanding this is Mother Sita, so I have to do some service to Mother Sita. So he fought very bravely. He fought very bravely, and finally, when he was about to take his last breath, Lord Ramchandra personally came to rescue him. So this was the great fortune. And so with the help of Sugriv, Lord Ramchandra was able to find out that where is Mother Sita. Mother Sita was in Lanka. So all of them, they came to the shore, the beach, and now it was a big question, the how should the whole army cross. Hanuman was very powerful, so Hanuman went and crossed Lanka, and he burned the whole Lanka and came back. But how will this entire army of soldiers, of monkeys, will cross the ocean? It was a big question. So Lord Ramchandra decided to take shelter of the ocean god. He fasted for 3 days. Although it was not appropriate for him to fast for 3 days, he simply could have instructed him and the ocean god could have come and helped. But Lord Ramchandra was performing a task of a human being. So he wanted to show a maryada. He wanted to show that what is the ideal way of dealing with the demigods. So he fasted. And what happened? The ocean god did not come. Then Lord Ramchandra showed his anger, he exhibited his anger. And then all the whale, all the sharks, everything in the ocean started to, the whole ocean started boiling. And Lord Ramchandra was about to dry it up. So when this was supposed to happen, ocean god came and said, my dear Lord, I'm very sorry. Please forgive me. Please accept my humble obeisances. I'm very sorry. What do you want, my dear Lord? I can give you the way for your army. But how will people remember your activity? So I am requesting you that please, with the help of Nala and Anil, make a bridge. Make a bridge over me. I will allow that. And then your glories will be discussed all over the three worlds for eternity. So on the advice of the ocean god, Lord Ramachandra built a bridge. And that bridge still exists. And in this way, Lord Ramchandra, with his army of Angada, Sugriva, Vibhishana and all, he attacked the Lanka and he killed all the great associates of Ravana. So Ravana got very disturbed that all my associates have died. Now he jumped in to the fight and he took an airplane and he entered the arena of fight and he started using so many different kinds of weapons against Lord Ramachandra. But Lord Ramachandra, he decided this is enough now, Ravana has to die. So Lord Ramachandra very successfully with his arrow, he pierced the heart of Ravana and Ravana died. Now, when a person dies, his family and everyone, they start crying, they lament. So many soldiers died on the battlefield. So many soldiers. Ravana himself died on the battlefield, and Ravana's son Indrajit, and so many different personalities, they died on the battlefield. All their wives, they came and they started to cry, and they used to take hold of their husband's body and they used to bang their head. Or they used to bang on their chest. What happened? Oh my dear Ravana, oh my dear husband, why did you go? I told you to be very careful with this Lord Ramachandra, but you did not listen to me. So Mandodari is one of the chaste wife. Although she is a wife of a demon Ravana, but she is considered as one of the chaste wives of amongst the great chaste wives. So Mandodari, she was knowing about the science of Lord Ramachandra, science of Ramachandra consciousness. She was knowing that Lord Ramachandra is the supreme personality of Godhead. And her husband has left. Now she was crying. She was saying that not only me, but all of us, so many of us, we have tried to explain you. Even Indrajit explained to Ravana, Kumbhakaran explained to Ravana, so many people they tried to explain to Ravana that Lord Ramachandra is Adi Narayan. Do not mess with him. But Lord Ravana did not listen. Now his wife is saying that, oh my master, you are personified trouble. You used to trouble others, you are personified trouble, you controlled all the demigods. So many demigods used to be there on his steps. There used to be various steps for the throne of Ravana, and all the demigods used to offer his dandavats, and Ravana, when he used to walk over them. Even great personalities like Shani was under his control. So Ravana was very powerful. When Ravana used to raise his eyebrows, all the demigods used to fear. So that was the situation. And then he's saying, but now, Mandodari is saying, what is now your situation? You have been defeated. And we, because of you, we have also defeated, and Lanka is gone to the enemies. So in this way, the Mandodari, she started lamenting, she started crying. And the situation was like that, that the entire whole battlefield has become a crying ground. All the wives of the associates of people of Lanka, they came there and they were crying. And then Mandodari said, Navai Veda Mahabhaga Bhavan Kama Vasham Gataha Tejanu Bhavan Sitayam Yena Nito Dasham Imam. So Mandodari is saying that, oh greatly fortunate one, you came under the influence of the lusty desires, and therefore, because of your lusty desires, you could not understand that Sita is like our mother. She is the worshipable deity. She was not an ordinary woman. She was a Jagat Janani. And now because of her curse, whose curse? Because of Sita's curse, everything is finished. The army of Ravana was very, very powerful. But because of whose curse was this army defeated? Sita's curse. Srila Prabhupada writes in the purport that Sita was very powerful. There is one side that she was a supreme Lord's wife, the goddess of fortune. That is a different story. But there is another angle to it, that not only was Mother Sita powerful, why was she powerful? Because she was chaste. So Prabhupada is saying that any woman who follows in the footsteps of Mother Sita can become equally powerful, similarly powerful. Now there are many instances in the history where the great and powerful women, they have defeated and they saved their husbands. Like one of the example is the Sati Savitri. She saved her husband from Yamraj. And there are descriptions of the chaste wives in the scriptures, like Mandodari was Ravana's wife, but she was chaste, so she was powerful. There was a time when Indrajit went to his mother. The first day when Indrajit came on the battlefield, he went to his mother and sought blessings for the victory. And Mandodari gave that day, she said, today you will be victorious. And to keep the word of Sati, Sati Sri, chaste lady, that particular day, Rama and Lakshmana both got defeated. Yes. They both got tied up by Indrajit's Nagpash. Both got defeated. That day, Indrajit went back and he was victorious. There was a big celebration. This was because of Mandodari's blessings to Indrajit, that he became victorious that particular day. Now, it is said that as a man has to follow the great personalities like Brahma, Narada, Mahajana, Yano, Gathasa, Panta, we say, for a man we should follow all the great acharyas. So similarly, for a woman, she must follow these great personalities like Mother Sita, Draupadi, Kunti, Devahuti. But how will she follow? She also has to hear about them. Hearing about Krishna, chanting the holy names, glorifying Krishna is the right of every living entity. So, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Sparanam not only applies for the men but also applies for women. Sometimes there is a philosophy that woman should not chant, woman should not do this, woman should not do that. But here Shukadeva Goswami is telling that one should follow the footsteps of great personalities like this Mother Sita, Draupadi, and how can a married woman understand them? She has to hear Harikatha. She has to hear Srimad Bhagavatam. When she hears and hears and hears about these great personalities, about this great woman, she will naturally develop those qualities which Mother Sita has. She will understand how to serve her husband. She will understand what is her duty as a wife, as a mother, as in different roles. She will understand, provided she hears Srimad Bhagavatam on a regular basis. So Srimad Bhagavatam should not be neglected. Srimad Bhagavatam must be heard on everyday basis, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya, by everyone. So that we can understand in our day-to-day life also how we can engage ourselves appropriately as per Sadhu Guru and Shastra. Now, Srila Prabhupada writes one statement in the purport. By staying chaste and faithful to her husband, a woman enriches herself with supernatural powers. What is this? How can a woman simply by remaining chaste to the husband can get supernatural powers? Yes. Srimati Radharani, she narrates a particular incident and that has been mentioned by Krishna's Kaviraj Goswami about a life of a woman who had supernatural powers simply by remaining chaste to her husband. In Anta Leela, chapter 20, verse number 57, it says, Kushti Viprera Ramani Pativrata Shiromani. There was a Brahmana who had leprosy and his wife was Pativrata Shiromani. She was best among the chaste women. But there was a problem. The husband had a leprosy, but there was a problem. Problem was that this Brahmana was attached to a prostitute in the village. Wife is chaste, very faithful, husband has leprosy, problem, disease all over the body, but husband is attached to a prostitute in the village. And he expresses the problem, oh, my dear wife, I want to have an association with that prostitute. So that wife thinks, so, my husband wants to, so she thinks, what is my dharma? So, she goes to that prostitute and she requests that prostitute, please associate with my husband. And she said, are you okay? Your husband has leprosy. I cannot associate with him. You look for someone else. He said, no, my husband likes you. She refused. But this chaste lady accepted a position of a maid servant in her house, and every day she started going to that place. She started serving for 1 complete month, she served her. And then finally, this prostitute said, okay, what do you want? You have served me for no cause you have served me. I'm not paying you, I'm not hired you, but still you're serving me. So what do you want from me? He said, I want that you should associate with my husband. Pati lagi kaila veshyara seva. And then she agreed. And she carried her husband on the back and she started walking towards the prostitute's house at dead of the night. And while going, the husband, his heart changed. He saw the qualities, the divine qualities she had gained because of her chastity. So the husband saw that and he said, my dear wife, husband was on the back of the wife, and he said, my dear wife, I do not wish to go, please, I'm very sorry, I'm so fortunate that I have a chaste wife like you, what do I need in this world, I just don't want anything, please take me back. She turned around and started walking back to home, but they were passing through a jungle. And while turning, when they turned back, husband's leg, he was walking in the dead of the night, husband's leg, it hit Markandeya Rishi, who was doing tapasya in that same forest. In Aditya Puran, in Markandeya Puran, in Padma Puran, this story is there. And Markandeya Rishi became angry. He said, who is that rascal who broke my samadhi? Whoever it is, next sunrise, he won't see the next sunrise. Tomorrow's sunrise, he won't see. He will die. And now, this chaste lady, she said, oh, my whole life I have spent in serving my husband, pure unalloyed devotion towards my husband, and now my husband is going to die tomorrow morning. No, I won't allow that. And she started praying. She said, if I am a chaste woman, if I have been loyal to my husband, if my husband is my life and soul, I have not thought of any other man in this my life, then I say that tomorrow sun god will not rise. And sun god, he said, oh, it's an order from a chaste woman. Sun god says, okay, I will not rise. On the one side it's a Markandeya Rishi, on the other side it's a simple lady, very simple lady, who was simply following her dharma, Pativrata dharma, and she became so powerful that she defeated the power of Markandeya Rishi. Women are very powerful, Baba. Women are very powerful than men. If they follow their dharma, they are very, very powerful. They are very powerful than this yogi, Markandeya Rishi. And then, Stambila Sturyera Gati. What happened? What happened? Stambila Sturyera Gati. She stopped sun god. And she saved her husband. But what happened? There was a chaos in the whole universe. All the demigods started saying, what happened, sun god? Wake up! It's your time to wake up. What happened? And the sun god refused. He said, I can't. And then, Tushta Kaila Mukhya Tina Deva, at that place, Brahma, Lord Shiva, Lord Vishnu appeared in front of that woman to stop this chaos. They were very pleased. They were very pleased by her. And the Lord Vishnu said to that chaste lady, please allow your husband to die. I will give her a new life. She dies, let your husband die, let the sun rise, let the husband die, and then I'll immediately bring him back to life. And because the Lord said it, she agreed. She agreed with the proposal. Now, this is the power of a chaste woman. From Mandodari's instruction, we can take a moral principle that one should not be influenced by the lusty desires of another's wife. This is a moral instructions which we need to understand. One should not try to see a woman lustily. And Ravana did that big mistake. Thus Ravana was condemned not only by Ramachandra, not only Lord Ramachandra condemned him, but also Mandodari's own wife was criticizing. He was saying that you did wrong. Even his own wife, he was condemning Ravana. Now, why? Why was she doing that? Because she was herself a chaste woman, and she knew the power of another chaste woman. And she knew that because of Sita, this whole Lanka is going to go. Ravana is going to get defeated. Now, but many times we see that the husbands, we expect that the wife should be very chaste, very loyal. But we see that the husbands are not up to the mark. This is a big question. I know while discussing this subject matter, I was very careful. I know what to say, what not to say. It is not an easy subject matter. I think this is one of the most difficult subject matter to speak at the current scenario in our society. I'm sorry to say this, but it's the most difficult subject matter. Many times we see that the husbands are not well behaved and they're dominating and very difficult to deal with. So how can a woman can follow dharma if the husband is like that? Okay, let's go into the life of another chaste woman to get our answer. Shariyati, the king Shariyati had a very beautiful daughter called as Sukanya. So once Shariyati and Sukanya, along with her whole army, they went to the house of Chavan Rishi. They went to Chavan Muni's ashram, Chavan Muni. They went to Chavan Muni's ashram. And after going there, they were playing, she was a young girl, she was playing with her friends. And Chavan Muni was doing his tapasya, sitting in a earthworm's. There was a place where earthworms were there, and underneath the earthworm's house, Chavan Muni was doing tapasya. And his eyes were glowing because of his power, the eyes were glowing. Sukanya was she was saying, what is that? And she took a stick and she put. And the blood started coming out from that mud. And then she became very afraid. And as soon as that offense was done by Sukanya, all the entire army there, it fell, even the king himself and the other soldiers just felt completely sick. And they understood that some offense has happened here. So he inquired, what has happened? And then Sukanya told that I have pierced the eyes of Chavan Muni. And now, Chavan Muni was very angry, very upset. So what will this king do? This king offered the daughter itself in service to this husband, to this Chavan Rishi as his wife. Now, it was an unusual marriage. Chavan Muni was very, very old, like a grandfather. And this girl was very, very young. Very, very young. Now, a great personality like Chavan Muni has the temperament of always wanting himself to be the superior, in a superior position. Such a person cannot submit to anyone. There are people like that. There are husbands like that. They cannot submit to anyone. And that is a problem with the wives. What can I do with this person? He's my husband, but he's very dominating in nature. What should I do with him? Now, his wife Sukanya could understand this attitude of him. Wife Sukanya was understanding this attitude of the husband. He was old. He was very old. Old people are sometimes gets very easily angry. Above that is a Chavan Muni, then husband. So she treated him accordingly. How did she treat Sukanya? Treat her husband according to his temperament. She understood that this is my husband's nature. Accordingly, she started serving the husband. And if any wife wants to be happy with her husband, I'm not saying this is Prabhupada's words. If any wife wants to be happy with her husband, she must try to understand her husband's temperament first and then accordingly try to serve him. This is a victory for a woman, Prabhupada writes. Today I am not speaking anything from any other place. I am only exclusively speaking from Prabhupada's purport, word to word. Because of the sensitivity of the subject matter. Even the dealings of Lord Krishna, his wives, who were they? They were daughters of so many great kings. But they accepted a position of a maid servant. And they pleased Lord Shri Krishna. So, however great a woman may be, however great she may be, but she must place herself before the husband in this way. Which way? Just like the maid servant, just like the queens of Krishna accepted Krishna, they became their maid servant. Similarly, one has to become like that. So, Prabhupada is saying that then the life of such a woman will be successful. Now, there was some incident in the life of Chavan Muni. Ashwini Kumar, the two Ashwini Kumars, they came to see Chavan Muni. And then Chavan Muni, he looked at himself that I am an old man and my wife is very, very young. And see my situation, I am ugly. I am an ugly looking person and still my good wife is serving me. That's okay, but I also want to become young. So he requested the two doctors, the two physicians, oh, Ashwini Kumars, can you please help me to become young and very handsome? I said, no problem. Absolutely no problem. So they took him into a lake and the three of them, they dipped together and when they came out, they all looked the same. Ashwini Kumar, and Chavan Rishi, they looked very handsome, very beautiful, very awesome. And they brought Chavan Muni in front of Sukanya. And Sukanya was very difficult for her to identify who is my husband. So Sukanya surrendered to Ashwini Kumar, said that I am a chaste woman. I don't want to accept any other person as my husband. A chaste woman will never accept any other man than her husband, even if the other person is more qualified than her husband, she will never accept. The other person might have thousands of good qualities more than her husband, but she will never accept such a person. She will want her husband only. So she prayed to Ashwini Kumar that I am not able to find out, but please you reveal it to me, where is my husband, so that I can serve him. So Ashwini Kumar were very pleased with the chastity of Sukanya, and they handed over Chavan Muni to Sukanya. Now Sukanya, she very intelligently, she dealt with Chavan Muni's situation, and now she had a very youthful husband. So when a husband is irritable, sometimes if the wife also becomes irritable, then their life at home is sure to get disturbed. It becomes hellish life. All the time, both the husband and wife, they fight. In the modern day, it is very difficult to find wives who are very submissive. But here is a message that how to deal with husbands. How Sukanya deal with her husband, even though he was irritable, and how she won his heart. Now, this is a tactic by which a woman can conquer the heart of the husband. And however irritable he may be, this is a formula given by our acharyas in the Bhagavatam. For a woman, how can she please her husband? Now, this should not be considered as that something that woman is inferior. In the Western world, people think that this is a slave mentality for a wife. But factually, it is not a slave mentality. It is a tactic which has been given. Whenever we work in some companies outside, what happens? We use different tactics to please our boss, right? We use different ways to please our boss, superiors. Even the wife, even the girls or the women that are working in the offices, they do the same. They have to do different tactics to please the boss, to stay in the company. So here the same thing. The acharyas are saying, Prabhupada is saying that use the same tactic in the home also. Certainly the husband should also be cooperative, and they should be helping and understanding. But if husband is not in that consciousness, but you got married, you're stuck up with someone, then how to deal with the situation? This is situation been given that use the tactic which Sukanya used. Talk sweet words and cook nicely. You can bring your husband in control. So in this case, we very clearly see that although Chavan Muni was not young, but an old person, he was supposed to be Sukanya's grandfather and was very irritable. But still Sukanya, very intelligently, she served the husband, and she was able to behave very nicely, and she won the heart. She was able to follow her dharma. So Mother Sita, she followed her husband and went to the forest, right? And she, although Mother Sita was a daughter of Videharaj, she could have chose to not go, but she chose to go to the forest along with Lord Ramachandra. Why? Because that was her dharma. Similarly, Gandhari, she was not blind, but she chose to remain blind. And when Dhritarashtra Maharaj took Vanaprastha and went to the forest, even Gandhari went to the forest because she followed her dharma. She was thinking that, she thought that if I, all the chaste women, they have their understanding that when the good times, I am supporting you, so even in the bad times, the wife should support the husband. Not that in the bad times comes, the wife gives up on the husband there, or they separate themselves. No. And these great personalities, these great chaste women, they have given so many instructions. They have given so many instructions in Srimad Bhagavatam and various scriptures for a chaste, how to become chaste, how to serve the husband. And Narad Muni has given a blessings. In a verse, Narad Muni has given a blessing. He says, Ya patim hari bhavena bhajat sri riva tatparaha hare atma hare loke patya sri riva modate. What is Narad Muni saying to Yudhishthira Maharaj? The woman who engages in the service of the husband following strictly in the footsteps of goddess of fortune. If someone follows in the footsteps of the great acharyas, what happens? Surely she returns to the abode of the Lord with the devoted husband. With the husband she will attain perfection. Not only that, she will herself deliver herself. By following dharma, she will deliver herself, but she will also deliver the husband if he is not a devotee. And she will happily reside in the Vaikuntha planets. This is what Narad Muni is saying for all the chaste women. What is their destiny? If a chaste woman is a devotee, then this is the destination. She will attain Vaikuntha planets. Even if she is not a devotee, still she will be promoted to the higher planetary system based on the strength of her dharma. So thank you very much. Hare Krishna. I'm certainly expecting questions. Hare Krishna.
Yeah. What was the reason that he did not listen to his wife and other things?
That is the power of lust. When you want something, when he was mad for Sita, so he wanted Sita very badly. I mean, without that, he was thinking that it will be difficult for me, and it became a prestige issue for him later on. So no, he did not accept anybody's instructions. Because he conquered the whole world. He conquered the demigods, he conquered so many people across the whole world. The whole three worlds were in control. So when situation like this arises, that because of a woman he has to accept the defeat, he said, no, I will not accept defeat for a woman. I will make her my wife, either hook or by crook. So he was maintaining that stand of his. And because of that, the whole thing happened. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. That is also there.
That is also one part.
Yes.
And other thing that you said, Nityam Bhagavatam Seva, we should always hear this Bhagavatam.
Yes.
So, when we speak that we should always hear Bhagavatam, and whatever the great men say, the common men follows. So, if I am saying that we should listen to Bhagavatam, and if I don't listen, and tell other one to listen, how other people can listen?
I did not get you, Prabhu. If I myself not following.
No, I suppose, or anybody, I'm advising somebody to do something, and if I don't do myself and ask someone to do, Prabhupada gave example of this one. A professor is smoking, and if you ask him not to smoke.
Yeah, one should not preach if he is not following. Any other question? Yes, Prabhu.
Because through enmity, from these absolutes, it would give it the highest destiny.
Ravana's case was different. He was already an associate of the Lord. But yes. But in general. But in general it is said Ante Narayana Smriti. So I think I should stick with that, Ante Narayana Smriti. Better he should think of Ram. But certainly the benefit will be there always. That when you are thinking of Sita, Sita is the dear wife of Ram. Hmm. So.
Because you cannot attain Ram without Sita's blessings.
Oh, definitely, yes. Definitely, yes. Definitely, yes.
Now, your lecture was very interesting. You give many examples of couples, wives, chaste women. But then the whole India is shaking on this point. Ram.
Why did?
Sita.
Why did?
Ram gave up Sita. Sita Manvas. So how can you give up such a chaste wife? Now, it's understood that Rajneeti giving the example of all these things. Prabhupada mentions that they wanted to taste separation, the mode of separation. Prabhupada mentions the books, right? They wanted to taste the viraha rasa, Rama.
Yes.
What is the example for common populace on the social level? Because it's the other aspect is viraha. But what is the example? Because there's a lot of populace. Even politically, you must be aware of this.
Yes.
People use this kind of.
Yes. This is a controversial question, and if you say what we understand that the pastime is there, that there was a complaint. You know this. There was a complaint.
We should expect maybe not all the foreign countries know about the complaint in India. It is different than all about the other countries.
There was a complaint that somebody's wife, I mean the wife of the washerman, I think so, she accidentally, because of the heavy rainfall around, she went for her work, and she, because of the heavy rainfall, she couldn't come, and that's why she had to spend a night with someone, I mean not with someone, but in someone's house. And the next morning when she comes, her husband rejects her, saying that you're not a chaste wife. So the whole thing goes to Lord Ramachandra. The wife goes to Lord Ramachandra. You accepted Sita. Sita also, I just stayed for one night. Sita stayed for so many nights in Ravana's house. You have accepted her, so you should order my husband to accept me. So husband said, I am not Ravana. I am not Lord Ramachandra. Ramachandra might be accept, but I cannot accept. So a deep thought went over Lord Ramachandra's mind. And then he sent some of his spies to find out what does people say about it. Unfortunately, the whole people started doubting on Mother Sita. And the situation so arose that that Lord Rama had to vanquish Sita to forest. And she was staying in Valmiki's ashram. So it's a very painful thought. It's a very painful thought.
But this is the problem. It is so painful. Therefore, many, even in Vrindavan, many scholars, devotees don't want to comment on it. It doesn't mean it didn't happen.
Even Goswami Tulsidas, he wrote Ramacharit Manas. And he stopped Ramacharit Manas at a place where when Sita and Ram were enthroned as a king and queen of Ayodhya. Because he was meditating on the future, he saw this thing and he said, no, I can't see that. So he also stopped there, so I also wish to stop here.
I'm saying you trying to avoid the hardship. My point
if you have any comments, you can please go ahead.
I don't have any comments, because you're a great scholar.
No.
This topic, right? Now, the thing is, people use this as an excuse that divorce is allowed in Vedic scripture.
Yes.
Would you agree or not agree? I would not agree with this. Because Manusmriti doesn't agree. But you see this pastime in Ramayana. On the social level, it looks like divorce. On the spiritual level, it's the viraha rasa.
Yes, yes.
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 Because it's not
Actually, for human beings, we should not imitate Lord Ramachandra. Yeah? That is why we have Sadhu, Guru and Shastra. A person before taking such a decision should always consult the sadhus, the spiritual master. In any given situation, it is most for a grahastha or anybody that he executes his life based on the instructions of the spiritual master and the sadhus. That is the best. So because we might understand that certain dharma in a certain way, but what is best suitable for us, the spiritual master and the guru and the shastra might explain us in a better way. So that's why it is always advisable that if we are put in a certain situation, and then we see that there are idols of, like Lord Ramachandra has left his wife. So better we should all, if we are in such a situation, it is best to consult sadhus, best to consult the spiritual master, and then execute what has to be done. This is what I'll advise. That depends on the situation. What's it? Different situations of different life of different people. Every same situation can't be there for everyone. Somebody is giving up his wife for some reason. We have to find out what is the reason. Situations are different. So that's why we have sadhu janas, guru janas. They will see, okay, what is the situation, and then they will accordingly guide them. Generally. So many examples, so many pastimes are there in scriptures. Chavan Muni's situation is there, Chavan Muni's and Sukanya's situation is there. Sukanya dealt in a very very beautiful way, very amazing way she dealt with her husband. But it might be not practically possible for everyone to deal with it. So that's why we all of us we need proper training and proper guidance at all the times. Just like there are pad pad yi vipadam. So at that, so I will say that pad pad, at every step we need guidance from sadhus. That's why it is said that graheshva vastito rajan kriya kurvanne tochit vasudevarpanam sakshat upasita mahamuni. The grahasthas especially, they have to offer everything to Vasudev, and they have to sit in the association of sadhus. Upasita, sit in the association of sadhus, mahamunis, and live their life under the direction of mahamunis. That is the advice given by Narad Muni to Yudhishthira Maharaj. And when we execute our life as per what the mahamunis want, then we will attain perfection. Hare Krishna Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Jai Shri Prabhupada. Jai Shri Radhe.